Welcome to Straight Line MTV, and today we're going to talk about 2020 in review.
Yay!
All right, welcome back to the channel, and today we're going to just talk about our first year for 2020 on our YouTube journey. We started in like March doing videos, mostly me, but we have our producer slash director slash warden here that helps us with our videos to join
us. I like to say I'm inspiring from behind the camera.
Our inspiration for our videos here to help us just kind of recap our first year on YouTube and some of the things that we've done and some of the things that we're looking to do in 2021.
Today we're going to be talking and asking Jacob questions about his channel and kind of what to look forward to in 2021.
Yes, so we've had some fun stuff going on. We started early this year doing bike reviews. That was really that's always been my passion, like watching Bible the Bike from Bike Magazine, Pink Bike Reviews. That's something I've always wanted to do. And luckily we've been able to kind of pull it off this year and bring in a bunch of bikes for review. So hopefully you tell some friends to subscribe to our channel so we can bring more awesome products and more content to you guys. Work with some brands on bringing bikes in too, do some more reviews.
So as a concerned investor, how many more bike reviews are you hoping to do this year? And are you going to change up the videos, like the type of videos you do? Or is it just be bike reviews?
Well, like I said, my passion, I love bike review. I love bikes. I've always wanted to ride a new bike every 6 months, but this past year, it seemed like every 2 or 3 months I was on a new bike. So that was even better. I will say the one drawback to that is you never kind of get a relationship with the bike. So you guys might see me keep a Straight Line MTV personal bike around hanging out as long, and bringing new bikes in. But I don't know, I think we did about 5 or 6 or 7 so bikes. I think a bike every month or two, I would like to continue that. But with your guys' help, subscribing and working with bike brands might help our fiscals a little better.
So on top of doing obviously all your bike reviews, which everyone has loved, what else do you want to kind of bring to your Straight Line MTV subscribers? Like what other videos? What do you think is relevant?
We did some how-to videos, which I think, you know, were helpful, like the Magura brake bleed, some, you know, what's in my pack, tubeless setup, and we did the Tannis armor. That was a good one. We worked with Tannis. Really, I'm driven by what the subscribers and our viewers want to see. So if you guys want to see something that we're not doing or maybe touch on some other how-tos, let us know in the comments. More than happy to do that. But, you know, I like to do some more basic stuff because I know we have a lot of new riders, especially with this COVID. It seemed like it just blew up. Mountain biking blew up. So I'd really like to start working on some more basics for some new riders, like, you know, how to change a tire, how to adjust a derailleur, which that's the one thing I'm not very good at, but we can work together. But you know, things like that, how to set pressure in your fork and your shock, you know, get some of the new people riding because somebody might start riding again, so she might need to see some of these videos.
I told him already that if I got a flat on a trail, I'd be walking back to the car. I don't even know how to do that, so it would be a good flats.
Tubeless flats because nobody wants to mess with an insert and some gunk inside your tire. So let's just push back to the car.
Okay, so out of all of the videos that you recorded in 2020, what is your favorite video and why do you like it the most?
So thinking about all the videos, I really appreciate and we put our heart into all of them. But if I had to pick one, I really enjoyed doing the Zeb versus the Manitou Mezzer. That was just a fun video because I was riding the same fork on the same bike, which I've never really done, to just test a product and kind of see the difference between both. So that one was fun because it was actually, you know, to put my mind into it and just really focus on the bike and this one specific aspect of the ride. So that was pretty interesting. Another one that I really enjoy that I didn't get many views on, but is my home trail just preview, just showing the trails that we ride. That one was just fun because, you know, I love riding Auburn is where I ride, and I wanted to share all that with the viewers because it is really an amazing place to go ride. So if you guys are ever in Auburn, this Auburn SRA has got some awesome riding and it's really great.
So speaking of riding, obviously you ride here in Auburn and you have done a lot of cross country rides, some Tahoe riding, Downeyville this year. What do you hope to ride in 2021 that maybe you haven't ridden in a while or really are hoping to get back on that trail or try something new.
Just looking at some of our followers on Instagram, just one place that's really struck me that I've seen your guys' videos and your Instagram clips is Arizona. There's a looks like there's some amazing mm-hmm. riding out there, especially specifically in Sedona. So I know some of our followers on Instagram, I see your videos. I'm like, man, this looks like some awesome riding. So mm-hmm. that's a place that I would love to go ride. I've always wanted to go to Moab mm-hmm. in Utah. So I don't know. I'd like, just seeing how the year shapes up for me, I would like to do more destination rides and more ride videos in general for the channel. If that's something you guys are interested in, let us know below.
So in 2020, you reviewed what, like 500 bikes is a lot. Out of all of the bikes that you were on, and even though a lot of them are different categories, and I know they don't all, you know, match up with each other because of different, you know, purpose, but what was your favorite bike to own that you were like pretty excited that you had it?
Oh man, they're all the bikes we reviewed were, I mean, it's, again, sounds kind of cliche. They're all awesome. I mean, we purchased them on our own, so we weren't sent them by anybody. So I feel comfortable saying that they were all great because they were. I will say that Orbea Occam was probably the one bike this year mm-hmm. that kind of flipped the switch for me. And the biggest reason is because it was my first 29er. And I'd always made fun of this guy I ride with because he'd always run 29ers. I'm like, come on. But that bike, it really, really was it was great. And it's a great bike all around. But I think just getting on my first 29er and just really seeing what that was about and really progressing my riding, That was a really awesome bike. And then another bike that just keeps popping into my head is our newest bike, the Transition Sentinel. That bike seems just like an amazing, just pretty much do a lot of things well.
Yeah.
And not kill me when I crash. And I feel
like you grabbed the Izzo and you were like, damn, I love this bike. I can see keeping this bike. I love it. And then you got the Transition and you were like, this is it. So you definitely like this bike.
And that's why I said I could talk about every bike. You know, the Rift Zone was a great bike. The Izzo is an amazing, just fun bike that just changes everything for my trail. Mm-hmm. So every bike, I think, has its, you know, the Meta AM. That bike was the most capable smasher of a bike I've ever ridden. So I mean, they all were great. It's just, I think those two bikes are the big standouts right now for me.
For your kind of social media platform, which one do you like enjoy kind of being on the most? YouTube, Instagram, TikTok?
Well, it's funny you ask this because you're making fun of me. As I say TikTok, because I, you know, we haven't been doing a lot of TikToks, but I've been trying to do more. I'll make a TikTok and I'll watch it 100 times. I mean, I don't know. I just enjoy TikTok. But they're all fun. Instagram is really fun. I like posting pictures of what we're doing so you guys can keep up and see what's going on.
You had a few giveaways this year. Yes. So that was fun. I know that Tannis was your most recent giveaway, and then obviously we did the Sweatbuster.
Tracks Factory.
So we kind of loved combining forces with other companies.
Yeah.
What would be kind of your goal this coming year? Like, do you want to do more giveaways? Do you feel like that was something you want to keep pursuing?
I did. I mean, I think the Tracks Factory Sweatbuster was, I mean, is just a small product as it is. Just that thing was amazing. I mean, and their customer service was awesome. They reached out and asked questions or sent me the hot sockies, the things for your toes to keep your toes dry, which I haven't used yet because it's not cold enough, but it's getting there.
I use them. Yeah. I put them in my Uggs.
Hot Uggies.
I love them.
So the Tracks Factory, they were awesome to work with, did that giveaway, and I use that thing every day. I have in two different helmets. Well, not my cracked helmet, but. And then Tannis Armor, that was another. They were awesome working with Colin over at Tannis Armor, the greats, helping us with a giveaway. I would love to do more giveaways and work with other brands. So, and again, that's where, you know, we want to continue to grow the channel so it's viable for the company as well as us. But
speaking of 2020, it was a really rough year for most people. Yes. And I think it definitely had its downs for a lot. What would you say were your ups and downs in 2020 in regards to, you know, everything? Mountain biking.
I'd say the highlight would be the channel. It's something I've always wanted to do, and I really enjoy giving advice. Like, I'm on the forums, like, answering beginners' questions, you know, or other questions of things that I'm familiar with. So it's become a passion of mine. It's just every question that's asked on our channel, I'm on there. Hey, this is what I think. And I try to give as in-depth response as I can. And I'd say a low light would definitely be my recent crash. Mm-hmm. I haven't crashed in I mean, I've taken a couple spills here and there, but nothing that serious for about 6 years. Yeah. I ride a little bit on the cautious side, so that's pretty bummy. You know, I'm still hurting, so I haven't been on the bike for a couple weeks. So
yeah. So speaking of 2021, what are your goals now for your channel and kind of things for maybe even your mountain biking in general, like your skills?
Oh, good question. I'd say a goal for the channel is I want to grow it. I want to bring our viewers, I want to bring you more content that you're going to enjoy. So whether it be ride reviews, bike reviews, product reviews, or just trail riding.
What is something that your straight liners would like to know about you? Because they don't really know you. They know your bikes and your riding style, but they don't really know you very well. Give them a little bit of Jacob.
I don't know if it's anything they'd like to know. Maybe they don't know is that, I mean, some of you guys have commented on my 64 Impala that I have in the background of some of my videos, but yeah, I'm a low rider. Mountain biking when I started would never have been anything I would have even thought I would ever be interested in.
But you're a low rider convert to bike riding.
But still low rider.
Still low rider. Yeah, hey, that's good. So out of all of the comments that you've gotten on your videos, are there any comments that really stand out as being like, oh my gosh, that was a really funny comment, that was a cool comment?
Yes. Funny you say that, and I pinned it on one of our videos. I think it's like Chucho Mucho or something commented, the great video, you deserve more subscribers. That really, like, those are the comments, like, I appreciate it. That was awesome. Mm-hmm. I mean, so those comments I really, and even constructive comments I appreciate. Like, mm-hmm. somebody commented once that I was underselling a bike and totally understood where they were coming from. So
can you give anybody a hint of what your next bike's going to be? Because I mean, at this point, you've been on that transition, what, 2 weeks now? It's time. It's TikTok.
Well, they did throw me, so I don't know. There's a lot of bikes coming out. They're all out of stock, so it's really hard. I know we've been lucky getting all the bikes that we've mm-hmm. gotten. One bike that I'm looking at and I'd really want to try, and it's never a bike I'd even thought I'd want to try, is the new Stump Jumper mm-hmm. Evo. It's gotten a lot of good accolades from Pink Bike, so that's a bike if I can get my hands on, I want to bring in, or even mm-hmm. just the new Stump Jumper itself, the smaller travel bike. After riding this though, I'm digging some of those short travel 29ers. They're pretty capable for that short amount of travel. Really, the transition spur, now that I'm loving the Sentinel, that spur is a bike that I really, really transition. Are you listening? I really want to ride that spur. So if you have one, let me know. And the Ranger from Revel. There's so many bikes out there I want to try. And Canfield's got new bikes out, and I love Canfield bikes. Favorite downhill bikes I've ever had were those. Excellent. Thank you guys for watching. Again, comment below. Let us know what you guys want to see from us in 2021. What mm-hmm. you like, what you dislike, what you hope to see more of. And don't forget to follow us on Instagram, straightline_MTB, TikTok, straightline_MTB, yep. and straightlinemtb.com. And
yeah, that's that.
We'll be going.
And here's to 2021.
2021.
Right. Okay. So now we'll see.
What is going on in this town? Our 2020 in review.
Okay. No, that was dumb.
What's you that? Do it then. You say the word.